newest pictures of Saturn on Nightcast.
Special program. But join us next week at our regular time, please. You wouldn't want to make me angry.
From Television City in Hollywood, Good Evening, Captain. Celebrating the 25th anniversary of Captain Kangaroo. With the captain's special guest star, Gene Stapleton. Barbara Mandrell. Starring Todd Bridges, Rene Dubois, Kim Field, Ted Lance, Wanda Payne, also starring Cosmo Allegretti, Grumpy Branham, and introducing Kids Rights by the Magic Carpet Band.
Good evening, Captain. Sponsored by Jell-O brand pudding. It's made with fresh milk and comes in 12 different flavors. It's been one of America's favorite desserts for over 40 years.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mike Farrell.
Hi. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. We're here because we want to wish a happy anniversary to someone very special. Someone we usually think of as talking to young people, but, you know, we as grown-ups value him every bit as much. That's what this is tonight, an adult celebration, a grown-up celebration for Captain Kangaroo. Well, he's going to be here very soon, and we'd like to ask you, all the grown-ups of America, to join some of your friends from television to help celebrate the 25 years of Captain Kangaroo.
Imagine an hour a day, 5 days a week, for 25 years.
Too bad man couldn't hold down a steady job.
Did you see all the telegrams that came for him?
I heard he even got one from Mickey Mouse.
Hey, everybody, can I have your attention for just a minute, please? You're not going to believe what I have here. This is a cassette of a Captain Kangaroo show from 25 years ago. It's the captain's very first show.
My name is Kangaroo. Yes, Kangaroo, Captain Kangaroo. I'm the keeper here of the treasure house. Why do they call me Kangaroo? See, look at this right here. See the great big pockets I've got? Look at that. Just loaded down. That's why, because I got pockets like a kangaroo.
You're here. I wonder. I have an idea that might be a nice celebration for everybody. Maybe you could all help me take a look at things that have happened in the last 25 years.
Yeah.
Oh, we can look at the changes that have taken place not only in Captain Kangaroo, but the changes in the American family. Oh, there've been a lot there, I'll tell you. Yeah. Would you help me?
Sure.
Yeah. You will.
If we're going to do that, maybe this is a good time for you to meet a very special person.
Very special person?
Uh-huh.
I'd be delighted to.
Oh, it's a beautiful plaque. Oh, it's beautiful. Here, see. Yeah. Well, I'll read it to you. To David Mann. Excuse me, I don't need these to read with. To Doris W. Pruitt, that's me.
The only known person in the United States of America who has watched every episode of the Captain Kangaroo program. Her proud record of seeing 7,189 episodes will stand forever. Oh. I can remember when it all began. 25 years ago, it was a regular morning, just like any other. My mother was helping me to dress.
Let's see if we've remembered everything. Something borrowed.
Sister's luggage.
Something blue.
Sister's garter.
Something old.
Sister's dress.
Perfect. Now we need something new.
Yeah, I wonder if Sister's got something that she hasn't worn
yet.
Oh,
darling.
Mother, if I could have something new that I could call my own. Maybe I do.
What's that you're watching?
It's a new TV show. Captain Kangaroo.
I like it. Doris, you haven't time for that right now.
Oh, Mother, you want me to have something new for my wedding, don't you?
Well, of course.
Well, this is it. Look, watch. Oh, that's marvelous.
Well, what about the ceremony? Everybody's waiting.
Oh, Mother, my marriage is going to last forever, but this may be the only chance I've got to watch Captain Kangaroo. You know how TV shows come and go.
All right, Doris, you leave me no choice.
Nice to see you.
Reverend, will you come in here, please? The groom go right over there, the bridesmaid here. And the organist, will you please be right here? Now, the family of the groom over here.
Shh, shh.
The family of the dear. Now, yeah, that's fine. It's lovely. Everything is beautiful. Oh, you all are so beautiful. Oh, dear.
See you outside today.
Okay, Reverend. You may begin the ceremony.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered together to join this man and this woman here. The present groom's bride has suddenly joined us. I can now see you.
To spend a quarter of a century in one spot and still find out what's been going on with the American family, this would have been a pretty good place. Yes, indeed. When these 25 years began, we were in the age of expansion. Big was best. This woman, for instance, drove to the market in an 8-cylinder beauty. Kind with the big fins on the back, remember? Yeah. She'll leave here taking the kids for their polio shots. On the way, she'll fill up her 18-gallon tank, and she'll hand the man a little less than $7. She and her husband wanted a big family, and they're having one. And they feed it with the big sizes of breakfast cereal. And they wash with that great big size of laundry soap. Everything was giant, super jumbo, extra large, family size.
I'll just go put these in your car, Mrs. Ferguson.
Thank you, Tommy. Here.
Oh, that's okay. You tipped me last time.
She tipped him last time. Can you believe that? That young man went on to become president of a bank. And today, you are tipping him 22%. A few years later, in the 60s, the markets were changing. And so were the people who came into them. More and more men were shopping with their wives. And the merchandise for sale in food stores reflected that fact.
Honey, did you remember to get charcoal for the barbecue?
No, I was so busy getting a new outfit for Judy's doll, I forgot all about it.
Oh, never mind. I'll just run back and get some.
Okay.
Where do they keep it?
In the far corner by the phonograph records.
Ah.
Imagine that. Charcoal and phonograph records in a food store. Well, no wonder retail sales just kept climbing and climbing and climbing.
Well, you know, I found it. You know, I could have sworn I recognized some food back there.
Food?
Nah, not in a supermarket.
And if prices started climbing, well, who cared? There were plenty of other benefits.
You're in luck, ma'am. Today we're giving away triple stamps.
Oh, honey, now we can make that down payment on the house.
On the house, with stamps. And they get their mortgage at 5%. A few years after that, some big changes happened to the household unit. In the 70s, there were changes to the things people bought. Changes in who those people were. As often as not, they were roommates. Shoppers like these girls made convenience foods popular. Frozen bags you drop into boiling water or pop into a microwave or toaster broiler. Frozen breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Everything from soup to nuts. For a while there, it looked like we might get all the way through the 70s without dirtying one real plate. In the 80s, hard on the heels of the roommate phenomenon, which created a change in a family structure, came this fellow, who brought the biggest change of all, the single person. Nearly a quarter of all Americans today live alone. They may be 20 years old or 80. They may shop at 2 in the afternoon or 2 in the morning. But they're changing the marketplace again. Soup for one, wine for one, little frozen things, frozen pizza for one, little frozen cheesecakes, little frozen pies, and of course, little frozen dinner.
Pardon me, do you have anything for frostbite?
You want to eat nowadays, you gotta pay the price. 89.
I sure do love the sound of good food.
Makes you hungry, doesn't it? 89.
Well, who knows what changes the future will bring to our supermarkets. One thing is for sure, you and I will be passing through these aisles, probably doing better at staying within our budgets than staying on our diets. 89. What am I doing?
89. Oh, honey, for me?
No. Anne, didn't you realize that Captain Kangaroo is celebrating 25 years on TV?
Really? Well, why didn't somebody tell me I'd have baked the captain a cake?
I think you just answered your own question.
Happy anniversary anyway, Captain, from the both of us.
I remember when I was a little baby, and I had my very first bite of Jell-O pudding, you know. Tasted so rich and creamy. Very first words out of my mouth that I ever spoke were, "More Jell-O pudding, please."
You said that? Mm-hmm.
Kids love Jell-O brand pudding, and because you make it with fresh milk, you know it's wholesome.
Did she just say something? "More Jell-O pudding, please."
You said that.
Listen.
I got her.
See?
Happy birthday, Laura.
Thank you.
Happy birthday, Laura.
Oh, chocolate nut cake, my favorite. Oh, you shouldn't have, Sarah. But I'm glad you did.
Here, you get the first piece.
With homemade topping.
No, with Cool Whip. It tastes fresh as homemade.
Mmm, you're right. Cool Whip tastes fresh as my mom's homemade topping.
That's why I wouldn't use anything else.
I guess with age comes wisdom.
Sweet.
Cool Whip non-dairy whip topping, now in the extra large recipe size.
Don't scare them.
Appreciating nature is a family tradition around here. That's why we eat grape nuts. The goodness of grape nuts comes compliments of nature. Comes from a special blending of nature's wheat and barley to bring out a special kind of taste that's good, nutty.
And crunchy.
Only grape nuts has it. Post Grape Nut Cereal with a crunchy good taste. Compliments of nature.
Saturday, catch the wild and wacky Bugs Bunny Roadrunner Show at its new time, 8:30 Eastern and Pacific, 7:30 Central. Catch it Saturday.
These are the experts, the NFL team of CBS Sports, the winning coach of Super Bowl XI, of Super Bowl IV, 10 years an NFL pro, television's outstanding sports journalist. This season, watch the NFL on CBS Sports. Watch the experts. They know what they're talking about.
First, but it began to affect my life in little ways. On our honeymoon... Oh, I'd rather not discuss what happened. But before my first baby was due, I told that doctor that that baby had to come before 8 in the morning or after 9. Or an hour earlier in the Midwest. And by the time that child was 7, I was a different woman.
Mom, I'm leaving now.
Where are you going?
To school.
School? But Captain Kangaroo is on. Don't you want to watch with Mom like we always do?
Mom, I'm 7 years old. School's more important right now.
Oh, well, suit yourself. Bye.
Bye.
But if you ask me, kids don't always know what's best. They're so grown up at 7. They don't know what grown up is.
No, Captain, no! Don't trust Mr. Moose. Don't you know what he's going to do? He's going to drop the ping pong balls again.
Just when you think there's nothing new under the sun, along comes a group of performers who practically invent a new kind of entertainment. I'd like you to meet some young people who've done just that. They're the Magic Carpet Band. They do a little thing called Kids' Rights. Every word that they speak, every idea they act out, comes from actual poems and stories written by children. Not a word has been changed. They haven't changed anything. They haven't corrected the punctuation, nor the grammar, not even the spelling. I think you'll enjoy them. Just remember, these are the words written by children and performed by Kids' Rights.
The robot right in my garage.
And my mom does not know about my robot.
My robot is ready. Okay, robot, you do what I say now. I like you, robot. Do you know that?
Yes, I do,
said the robot.
I like you, too.
The end. One day, a girl decided to join baseball.
But no one would let her play. Ooh. So, one day, a team picked her. Her team went all the way to the finals. The game was tied 1-1, and the girl was up. And she hit a home run
and won the game for them.
Once upon a time, about 200 years ago, there was a man. his son,
and dog.
Oof. They were going camping in the woods.
They were taking their dog along.
They packed their stuff and left.
They were nearly there.
When they got there,
the dag went and got lost.
But he found his way back by footprints. When they got home, they were happy.
Because they had a bunny living in the house.
They lived happily ever after.
Thank you for bringing me.
That's what I want right now. I'm scared. I need help. A talk is what I need. Mom helps me sometimes. Other times I don't feel right with Mom, so I go to Dad. Sometimes I wish I had an older sister, but I only have an older brother who probably wouldn't understand me. One person understands me. So tonight, I'll talk with me. And tomorrow, I'll see what happens next.
And thank you for my supper with spaghetti.
Will you ever forget your first time on stage? Mom said my entrance was dazzling, but when my knee stopped knocking, I enjoyed it. Backstage, the main attraction was Kool-Aid. What better way to celebrate, then or now? Compare it to soda. Including my sugar, Kool-Aid unsweetens about one-third the price, has vitamin C, plus a fruity taste that's a real showstopper.
You loved it as a kid, you trust it as a mother. Kool-Aid brand unsweetened soft drink mix.
If you take the whiteners out of Final Touch, I won't buy it.
We're not taking them out. We're putting improved whiteners in.
I like Final Touch the way it is right now. I think it's a good product.
Look, one wash was done with Final Touch fabric softener, the other with new improved Final Touch. Which is better?
This one is a lot whiter. It's more sparkly. It looks whiter. It's soft, too. And it really is white looking. I'm amazed.
For a soft and whiter wash, add the Final Touch. It's improved.
I wouldn't have believed it.
Tomorrow morning, Stardust Stampede. Stardust Stampede to breakfast with beef. Introducing Firebrand Beef Strips from Swift. Strips of pure beef. Firebrand beef. Genuine beef through and through. With a crisp, smoky flavor that's made for the morning. So move over, bacon. Move over, sausage. Make way for Firebrand Beef Strips. Firebrand. New from Swift.
Captain Kangaroo will be back in a moment with Gene Stapleton, Barbara Mandrell, and Mike Farrell. Monday on WKRP in Cincinnati, Dr. Johnny Fever is looking for love.
There's been some mistake.
Who will become Mrs. Fever? Then wild fantasies make hilarious comedy.
Mark the clean, Mark! Mark the clean, Mark!
On the Tim Conway Show, starring Harvey Korman. It all happens Monday night.
Major decisions affecting you continue to come from the Reagan team's vacation headquarters in California. Leslie Stahl covers them on the CBS Evening News Monday.
This is CBS.
It's time to play McDonald's Double Choice Quiz. Okay, you've answered question one correctly. You can take a McDonald's food prize now, or risk it all and go for question two.
I'll play for more.
Ha-ha! Who was America's first president? To get your free quiz card, just buy a medium Coke or tab at participating McDonald's.
Abraham Lincoln.
You're absolutely wrong. Ah, but you could have won.
I'm a chicken sandwich.
Play McDonald's Double Choice Quiz. But remember, if you don't win, don't tell anybody.
Guardian Angels in another Bay Area city, the details at 11.
It's a pleasure to welcome a new friend to this anniversary celebration tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, Barbara Mandrell.
Barbara, I'm so, so happy to welcome you to the show.
You know, Captain, it's interesting to think about all the changes during the years that your show has been on the air. And I was remembering the dolls that I had as a little girl, you know, comparing them with the different dolls that the children have today.
Oh, yes. You know, fashions come and go. But the dolls of the last 25 years have a story of their own.
May I help tell that story?
May you? You certainly may.
Thank you, Captain. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to our retrospective collection of American dolls and their fashions. Please join me in giving a warm welcome to... That's right. It's Barbie and Ken. Under their wardrobes, which could cost more than the national budget of many emerging nations, you'll find that both Barbie and Ken have the proportions of the ideal 1955 teenagers. Aren't they a lucky couple? For all of us who enjoy the morbid, here is Sally Sickness. You'll notice that Sally is wearing arm and leg casts, glasses, bandages, and comes with her own tiny crutch. Continuing our medical motif, here is Visible Woman, a product of that wonderful year, 1959. What child doesn't enjoy seeing veins, arteries, and the entire nervous system in his and or her playthings? Here now, Baby Love a Bubble shows us her natural hairdo and authentic features. And this little miss is enjoying a delicious snack. Modeling can make a girl very thirsty. She's as moral as she is huggable. May we present Patty Prince. From the world of science fiction, here's Robot Rodney. It's hard to imagine cuddling up to him at night, but there's no accounting for taste. Now it's guest star time, so let's have a nice round of applause for the Incredible Hulk. O.J. Simpson. For our next meeting, when the subject will be this, the Captain Kangaroo doll. You wind it up and it goes for 25 years.
Yes, every morning. I live for that hour every morning. Nothing else seemed to matter. The years went by in a blur of chickies and bunnies and puppies. Oh, and then, of course, my beloved Mr. Green Jeans. And before I knew it, my little boy had turned into a man.
Mom?
Mom?
Shh.
Mom, I'm leaving now.
That's nice. Where are you going?
I'm going to college, Mom.
College? Oh, really? Oh, but Captain Kangaroo is on. Sit down and watch it with Mom like we used to.
Mom, I'm 18 years old. I want to learn about the world now.
Oh, what world?
The real world.
The real world? What about the world of ping pong balls? Doesn't that mean anything to you anymore? Oh, don't you remember how you used to love it when Mr. Moose dropped the ping pong balls on the captain? Oh, how you used to laugh.
I never laughed at that, Mom. You did. I'll be home for Christmas.
All right, dear. Well, be sure you get here by 8 in the morning in case the captain does a Christmas show.
Oh. A friend is a stranger you just haven't met yet. And many a stranger has knocked on my door. 25 years makes me want to go for 25 more. Andy Williams, Alan Arkin, Bobby Vinton, Milton Berle, Cindy Williams, Penny Marshall, Carol Channing, Minnie Pearl. Dolly Parton,
my friend. That's why I hope with all my heart your show will never end.
I want my child to feel that love that made me feel secure. With me, my child, and Kangaroo, three's company for sure.
Happy anniversary, Captain!
Tony, your own museum?
Uh-huh. Full of all the scoundrels who've ever tried to steal the secret formula for Kellogg's Sugar Frosted Flakes.
There sure are a lot of them.
They all knew it was the secret formula that makes Frosted Flakes such a delicious part of this nutritious breakfast.
The secret taste of Frosted Flakes makes Tony say...
They're great! Now that's what I call stiff competition.
Better.
You're gonna wake Mom up.
I didn't say it.
Better.
You're parking margarine.
Better.
Let's see. Well, what do you think?
That's good.
It's butter.
Parquet.
What's going on down there?
Parquet margarine from Kraft. The flavor says
butter.
That is a family. And a family, if you come to think about it, is like a little country. It has a leader and a set of rules, sort of a constitution that everybody follows so they all get along. And this family, like every other family, has rules of the house. Called y'all here together today to clear up a few misconceptions and to get this operation running smoothly once again. Now, if I may call your attention to the board in the center of the Oval Office. Watch carefully.
Oh,
no.
Well, do Moses.
Now, if you will notice here, I have a few words and phrases when put together form a sort of constitution.
Do we also get a Declaration of Independence?
When you're the head of the house, you can have whatever you want. Okay, now moving right along. Rule number one, beds must be made and clothes put away every day.
Does that include your room, too?
Of course. Now, your mother makes our bed and puts away my clothes every day. That's why our room is so neat.
How come you have someone to do it for you when we have to do it for ourselves?
Yeah.
Because that's the way it is.
That is the way it was.
Tell him, Mama.
But from now on, in this great democracy of ours, you make up the bed every other day. And also pick up your own clothes.
Talk to him, daughter.
As I was saying, the beds will be made every other day, and the clothes will be picked up at the discretion of the dropper. In a government, each person is given a specific task on a rotating basis. For instance, in the kitchen. Now,
Johnny,
you will set the table on Mondays, clear the table on Tuesdays, dump the garbage on Wednesdays, pour the water and fill the water bottle on Thursdays, and stack the dishes in the dishwasher on Fridays.
But I won't be home Wednesday. I got basketball practice.
No problem. Sissy, you will dump the garbage on Wednesdays and Thursdays for Johnny, and Johnny will pour the water, fill the water bottle, and stack the dishes in the dishwasher for you on Fridays.
I can't. I've got Girl Scouts on Thursday.
No problem. Grandma, you will set the table, clear the table, dump the garbage, pour the water, fill the water bottle, and stack the dishes in the dishwasher on Thursday. Johnny, you will then dump the garbage for Grandma on, let's see, on Mondays and Fridays. And Sissy, you will then pour the water and set the table on Mondays and Tuesdays, which leaves Mom free to do the floors on Saturdays.
I got Gray Panthers meeting Monday nights. And Tuesdays, I have karate training. Yeah!
No problem.
Better not be.
Okay. Now, taking care of the dog. He must not eat food from the table and he cannot sleep in your beds. Now, if there is anyone that has anything to say about this, let them speak now or forever hold their peace. Well, that's T-O-U-G-H. Who taught that dog how to spell?
Grandma.
Okay, this is my final rule. Think of the other person.
That's kind of like the golden rule, isn't it?
Hey, that's right, Johnny. And if we observe this one rule, we really have no need for all of the others.
Does that mean I can stay up and watch the Dukes of Hazzard?
Not on your life.
Unless we become a Nielsen family.
We always hope that when a man and a woman marry and begin to build a family, they'll continue to grow together and that their marriage will thrive. Realistically, though, that does not always happen. And some of the most beautiful songs are the result of sadness, separation, and loneliness. We've asked Barbara Mandrell to sing such a song.
The best of friends, the best of lovers, that's what we used to be. I just wish we'd ended up the way we started out. From one little room where we loved each other to this big two-story house. We wanted the best. I'm afraid that's what we've got now. Best of strangers, no one could do it any better. We live here separately, together. We're the best of strangers. We share a ceiling and a floor. We go to bed, we turn out the light, we stare at different walls. Most of the time, we don't even say good night. I don't touch you, you don't touch me, except passing in the hall. And then when we do, we both apologize. The best of strangers, no one could do it any better. We live here separately, together. The best of strangers, we share a ceiling and a floor. We're the best of strangers. We're the best of strangers.
Hold my duck.
Hey, where are you going?
I've got spring cleaning to do.
It's not spring.
Lysol deodorizing cleaner is like spring cleaning in a bottle. Anytime. Lysol cleaner kills germs in the bathroom. It fights mold and mildew down here. And cleans greasy dirt in the kitchen.
And it smells like spring, fresh and clean. That was easy.
Duck soup.
Lysol deodorizing cleaner. It's spring cleaning in a bottle. Anytime.
You're gonna love, love my carpet. You know, there are three wonderful ways to love, love my carpet, because love my carpet comes in three wonderful scents. Citrus fresh, floral fresh, and regular. Love my carpet gets dog, cat, and smoke odors out of the rug. Just sprinkle it on and your whole room smells fresh, clean. And all three love my carpet scents keep me smelling fresh. That's why you'll love, love my carpet. Pick 'em up. I do.
There once was a man called the Captain. the best in the world at adapting. We all love his smile and his charm and his style and the good-looking package they're wrapped in. Happy anniversary, Captain, and many more.
Story. Oh, no, wait a minute, I forgot. I want to tell you about one other time when my son, Freddie, brought his new baby daughter, my grandchild, over to see me.
Oh. Mom, isn't she the most beautiful baby you've ever seen?
Yes, she certainly is. Oh, but don't hold her that way.
What's wrong with the way I'm holding her?
Turn her around so she can watch the captain.
Mom, she's only 6 months old.
Well, and it's about time she learned about Mr. Green Jeans and Mr. Moose and Bunny Rabbit.
You're still serious about that, Kangaroo, aren't you?
You bet I am. Here, let me hold her. Yeah, I know what's important in this world for grown-ups and kids. And any granddaughter of mine is going to have the finer things of life, just like you did.
Mom, you're incredible.
I know. Watch now. Look, Mr. Moose is going to drop the ping pong balls on the captain.
Oh, Mom.
Oh, sit down, Freddy. You're too serious. You never learn how to have a good time. Yeah, isn't that fun? Watch. That's the story. 7,189 episodes. And thanks to Captain Kangaroo, the last 25 years have been wonderful. And I don't know where the time is
going. Come on, Grandma. You've talked enough. Now let's go home and watch Captain Kangaroo.
Wait a minute, dear. That's my granddaughter.
Come on. Right.
Bye, and thank you.
Nice if every child were part of a family, and every family began with love. Here are two very good friends of Captain Kangaroo and some songs about a family in which times may change, but the love remains the same. Mike Farrell and Gene Stapleton.
Two, turn on.
when the kids grow up and leave us, we'll sit and look at that same old view.
Just we two, where are the kids who used to be Jack and Jill?
The folks who like to be called what they have always been called. Suckers walk the plank.
If you land on your tail,
if you land on your tail,
every time that you fall,
every time that you fall,
must be a reason for it.
Who needs a reason for it? Love
is a reason for it.
Introducing the incredible flexible fabric bandage.
When you have to move like this, you need a bandage that moves with you.
New Band-Aid brand flexible fabric bandage. It's made of a breathable elastic fabric, so it flexes when you flex and stretches when you stretch.
When you have to move like this, you need a bandage that moves with you.
New Band-Aid flexible fabric bandage. It moves with you, so it stays with you. A new bandage to stick with from Band-Aid brand.
Some clown took my sugar smacks.
Jacob.
My shoe. Oh, give me my smacks.
Smack, smack, sugar smacks.
I dig them.
I dig them too.
Give me a smack, and I'll smack you back. Fun to eat those puffs of wheat. Kellogg's sugar smacks.
Mmm. Why did you hide them here?
I wanted to get into shoe business.
Kellogg's sugar smacks, part of this nutritious breakfast.
Dig them.
25 years is quite a stretch to host a TV show. As one who's done some time myself, sir, I know. The children all adore you because you're like a little elf. When I grow up, I'd like to be as nice as you myself. Many happy returns, Captain.
Oh, thank you, Dick. Thank you very much. Oh, that's so pretty. Thank you all for the flowers. And thank you for the good wishes and kind words.
Captain, you mean every one of them.
Oh, I really do appreciate it. Oh. And they're such pretty flowers.
Thank you, everybody.
Congratulations. Now, Captain, are you ready to start the next 25 years?
Only if you two are with me.
That's what I like to hear. The three of us together, like always.
Right.
We got to stick together. You and me, pals forever. Basically, we're two of a kind. Birds of a feather, rain or shine, we'll stick together and live each day. Come what may, wherever the road may wind. Like true friends, we'll stick together and make out fine.
That's together?
Hold it, hold it. Party's not over yet, Captain. We have one more surprise for you.
Oh, of course. What's an anniversary party without a cake? What a cake.
Ta-da!
Captain Kangaroo, my name is Doris Wagner Pruitt, and I am the only known person in the United States of America who has watched your show 7,189 mornings without a miss. Oh. They gave me a platform.
Beautiful.
Thank you all. Thank you for this wonderful celebration. And thank you for sharing so much of the last 25 years with me. I do appreciate it. And thank you very much for sharing so much of the last 25 years with me. Thank you for all the joy that you have brought me. God bless and love, children. Oh.
Tonight, Bo and Luke have their hands full with empty graves, missing bodies, and Boss Hogg on the rampage on the Dukes of Hazzard next, following Newsbreak. The Incredible Hulk, starring Bill Bixby and Lou Ferrigno, will return next Friday evening at 8 o'clock, 7 Central and Mountain Time.
Saturday, catch the wild and wacky Bugs Bunny Roadrunner Show at its new time, 8:30 Eastern and Pacific, 7:30 Central. Catch it Saturday.
Saturday, the balance of nature shatters and animals unite to destroy man. Linda Day George stars in Day of the Animals, Saturday night. Could it really happen?
Good evening from CBS News. This is Newsbreak. There's good news for American motorists tonight. OPEC, the oil cartel, has failed to agree on a price increase. And Saudi Arabia, the largest foreign supplier of oil to the U.S., will stick to its current price of $32 a barrel. Analysts say that could mean even slightly lower prices for consumers. A report issued by the House Interior Committee criticizes basing the MX missile system in the Western Desert, saying it would damage the environment without protecting the nation. President Reagan has not decided the issue yet, but a key senator believes the administration has abandoned the idea of an airborne MX system. Labor Secretary Raymond Donovan says the White House might conceivably consider an extended grace period for striking air controllers, but administration spokesmen say there's been no change.
Angelo Dundee drinks Natural Light.
Yeah, for me, Natural Light's got a taste that knocks the other lights out.
Hey, a unanimous incision.
I'm David Dow, CBS News, Los Angeles. More news later on this CBS station.
This is CBS.
These days, everyone's trying to sell you a chicken sandwich.
A chicken burger. Ooh, it's just for you.
Chicken sandwich? Ahoy, my boy.
Chicken sandwich Tijuana. Do you wanna?
But nobody makes a chicken sandwich like the Chicken Experts. Kentucky Fried Chicken. Ours is a real breast filet. Nothing chopped, pressed, or rolled. And only we make it the Colonel's special way.
Kentucky Fried Chicken. We do chicken right.
Right.